Employees of Reddit, I was just accused of stealing water. What crazy accusation has an employee or supervisor made about you? I'm on a diet that requires me to drink a metric shit ton of water. Shout out to my friends over at r/Kato. So I carry around a 1 liter Nalgene bottle at all times. I'm a mid-level manager at a 60-person company. At the end of the workday, on my way out I pass the water cooler and fill my bottle up for the commute home. Yesterday I was doing just that, when our office manager walked up and said the following: "You're leaving for the day. Water is for employees to drink when they are working in the office only." I laughed it off, finished filling my bottle and headed home. I thought she was kidding, or at the very worst having a shitty day and lashing out. She wasn't. Today I get into the office with an email from her to myself, my boss, our CEO/founder, and our HR person saying that I am stealing from the company, that I didn't stop filling my water bottle and immediately apologize when confronted, and that she is officially reporting this behavior and asking to have it documented. Needless to say, we all had a pretty good laugh about it. My boss called me in hysterics and could barely form a sentence. He was laughing so hard, and someone wrote, "Is proper hydration good for the company?" on my water bottle. Our office manager, however, is just walking by my office and glaring this morning. TLDR, I'm the Daniel Ocean of our office water cooler. I had an employer of mine write me up for stealing trash. In reality, at the end of my shift, one of my duties was to gather all the trash. Oftentimes, I would pick through the trash and sort all the paper, pop cans, and water bottles in our company's recycle bin. We had a special promotion with our trash company, in which our company would get money based on the number of pounds we recycled. It ended up being $1,500 per month, and we didn't pay our trash bill. So long story short, I got a final write-up for stealing company time for sorting our recyclables. So I stopped. The following month, our manager was pissed that she had to pay a trash bill. She called the trash company, and the company told her that the past 2 years she didn't pay for trash because our company would recycle so much, we would get a $1,500 check and free trash service. My boss thought that the checks were a bonus for her. Anyhow, the district manager was reviewing the write-ups, and saw I got written up for stealing trash, so he called me up and asked me what was going on. I told him the story about the trash company and their promotion. He congratulated me for a job well done. The next day he flew in to talk to my manager. He asked my manager what happened to the $20,000 that she got from the trash company. Apparently, she tried to pin it back on me, and our district manager promptly fired her. After escorting her out, he called me into the office. He told me what happened in that meeting, and offered me a promotion to assistant manager. I was working retail at Best Buy at the time, and they had me working in MP3 players/cell phones, despite the fact that DVD/video games were really more my wheelhouse. But, I worked where they told me and I did my job well. During Christmas season, it got really busy, so everyone was running around helping every department. I was hanging out in my own section when a woman comes over, asks about some headphones, and I help her. She then asks me if the Dance Dance Revolution Mad Cats mat she bought for her daughter is any good, and I ask if she has any of the games. She didn't, and showed her a slightly more expensive, but better, copy of Economy Mat with a game. She thanked me, since she didn't even know it needed a game, and went off. My department manager comes up behind me, tells me to meet him in the break room in 5 minutes, and rips into me. He says that the department with the best revenue gets bonuses, only true for him, not for the rest of us below him, and we shouldn't be helping customers in other sections get more expensive things. He says he'd be shocked if I made it past the winter. I just say, "Yes, sir," and go back to work. Come January, I get fired by department manager recommendation. So, when you go to Best Buy, know that all the departments have their own agendas with you. My first job with the state was awful. My supervisor was an idiot in every sense of the word. I remember once, I was called into a meeting with our bureau chief. He asked us some questions about office matters, and my supervisor flat out made up lies about me that were completely against my character. I couldn't hold in my frustration and blew up at her, told my bureau chief I wasn't there to play childish games, and then walked out of the meeting. I ended up winning that one, and got a promotion that paid twice as much as that terrible supervisor. It was one of those awesome revenge moments where nobody got hurt. I worked in a souvenir shop at an amusement park. It was the 4th of July, one of the busiest days because of the park's fireworks show. We were also understaffed. The shop was just inside the gate, so it would get swamped just before closing, as people bought the stuff they didn't want to walk around with all day. I was left alone in the shop, just before closing time running the cash register as people flowed in. It was utter chaos. While closing out the register that night, it was noticed that a large stuffed animal had been stolen. The manager simply could not fathom that one person manning a swamped store can't prevent theft, because not all the displays are within sight of the register. I think it must have been a team effort, with one or two people getting my attention in one area, while the other walked off with the toy, but I didn't say that because I really didn't know when or how it happened. Bastard accused me of being in on it, and looking the other way while a friend stole it, so we could profit later. I didn't even know what to say. I was 17, it was my first job, and I cried for days under the assumption that every job I'd ever hold would be like that one. There's 6 tacks of cash to be made on the underground giant stuffed animal market. In one of my darker life periods, I was doing part-time tech support for a dinky computer shop here in town. The owner was a pill-popping nut job that kept a loaded gun in a drawer in the front desk, and regularly cheated his customers. Anyway, I'm working one day, and one of the other techs who had been there forever and a half tells me to go install a modem in some guy's computer. I'm shaking my head, because this is in 2009, and I can't believe anyone would be requesting a modem. I ask him if he's sure before I go out there. He said he was. So, I go out, and sure enough he doesn't need a modem at all. He needs a wireless car door adapter. I call. Go back to the store, get the card, head back to the customers, install it, head back, and yell at the guy for being a dumbass, as common sense would tell anyone reasonably competent that he didn't need a modem. Long story short, next week the boss comes in, and fires me because the other guy made up some absolute crap about me drilling a hole in a motherboard to fix a PC, which made no sense whatsoever. On my way out, I rolled my eyes and said, "Fine. Whatever." Grabbed my stuff, and left. The owner freaks out, and follows me into the parking lot, yelling and screaming and ranting and raving and trying to pick a fight. I just calmly walked to my car, went home, and had a beer. I found out later that shortly thereafter the other guy was busted for fraud, and the owner went bankrupt, shortly before popping a ton of pills and blowing his brains out. Several years ago, I was working for a sporting goods store, as the customer service desk guy. Mostly what I did was returns and some special stuff with Ticketmaster, and hunting/fishing licenses. While it wasn't a glamorous job, I liked it, because I'm an outdoors guy, and so the clientele were fun to talk to. One day, we were informed we were getting a new general manager, as the old one, decent guy, but distant, was being transferred. The new manager was a raving harpy arsehole cunt trash. She enjoyed making employees upset, didn't give a flying duck about our customers, did nothing to improve anything about the store, and kept the other managers in her office with endless meetings about improving the store. After a few months of this bullshit, and seeing some of the high school girls hired to work in shoes crying after her ranting at them, I had enough. I wrote a rather eloquent letter to corporate about her behavior and actions, and had several employees sign it. 2 days later, several regional higher-ups arrived, and proceeded to chew her out big time. She was suspended for 2 weeks, and told that if the store didn't improve within the next quarter, she'd be fired. But that's just the beginning of the story, dear reader. I thought I had won. But no, I had not. Apparently, she found out it was me who wrote the letter, probably got told by one of the other employees, I'm not sure, and wanted revenge. So she got into the computer system, and started to fake records showing I had been selling gift cards to myself, pocketing the cash difference, and then buying merchandise with those cards. mostly candy slash pop slash small stuff, which she was probably pocketing since our accounts weren't ever off. She then called in loss prevention, who weren't doing their jobs too well, because they didn't look closely at the files, and their last edited dates, yay for Windows NT Office, because they believed it and called in the county sheriffs. Two deputies came, looked over the evidence, to their credit, they asked, "Are you sure? And, can you explain this?" several times, and I got the feeling they were unsure about the whole mess. Nice guys, too. They offered to take me out through the back, instead of parading me past customers, let me have a cigarette before we left, and were generally courteous and respectful, and ended up arresting me on felony theft charges. Taken to jail, booked, the whole shebang. I was in tears for pretty much 3 days. But I knew this was bullshit, so I go to my parents to help hire a lawyer for me. Told him the whole story, and said under no circumstance were we pleading out to anything. He said okay, and set up a meeting with the DA to talk about motions and such. When we arrived, the DA was all smiles and very polite. He informed me that the paperwork wasn't quite done yet, but that they were dropping all charges, and filing false report charges against my old manager. The investigators had looked over the evidence, and found that A, the files for almost 3 months worth of thefts had all been edited on 2 days, both of which I had not been present for, but that she had. B, they had all been edited from her computer, a computer I did not have access to, and C, several of the thefts occurred on days when I was in the system as being out of state on vacation. I felt a lot happier after that, and felt even better when my ex-boss was found to have fled the state, and checked herself into a mental hospital for a nervous breakdown. She was eventually brought back, charged, and convicted. Last I saw, she was an assistant manager at a gas station, while I'm now a federal firefighter, and in school to become a police officer, and will make damn sure I read over every bit of evidence put in front of me. It's only after I saw her pumping gas that I could claim victory over her. Mine isn't nearly as compelling as others. A year after I started working for a company as a graphic designer, turned out I was also the marketing and web design departments as well. My wife got pregnant with our first child. This was an office filled mostly with middle-aged women. I was in my mid-late 20s, and they were all excited, even threw us a baby shower. All goes well and my son is born. And I take 2 weeks vacation time to be with my wife and child, 2 weeks I had saved up. I come back and my boss is suddenly very aloof and non-communicative with me, where previously she and I were pretty close. This goes on for several months until I learn budget cuts have eliminated my position, effective in 6 months from the time I found out. Through my co-workers I found out that my boss was pissed I had a baby, and that I wasn't dedicated to the cause. She was also at the budget meeting, and initially there were no cuts to our division, but she threw me under the bus saying my work was non-essential. So here I am with a young family and staring down the barrel of unemployment. Turns out though that another company had been following my work, and were eager to sign me on. Needless to say I didn't do shit for the next 6 months, and am now happy at my current position and making more moolah to boot. Their company is now in the shitter, and I poached one of their biggest clients on the way out.